Hello everyone, I'm Abhimanyu Jain, student volunteer at Green Brigade, the Environmental Society of College of Vocational Studies. From today onwards, we will be periodically posting videos about different protected forests of India and we will understand how to support our biodiversity, the species they sustain and how these forests are under threat. Let us know our India. Of India. Reserve forests and protected forests differ in one important way. Rights to all activities like hunting, grazing, etc. in reserve forests are banned unless specific orders are issued otherwise. In protected areas, rights to activities like hunting and grazing are sometimes given to communities living on the fringes of the forest who sustain their livelihood partially or wholly from the forest resources or products. In today's time, the protected forests face far more danger than unprotected forests. Now I am going to talk about Jim Corbett National Park. Jim Corbett National Park is the oldest national park in India and was established in 1936 as Haley National Park to protect the endangered Bengal tiger. It is located in Nainital district of Uttarakhand and is named after Jim Corbett, a well-known naturalist. The park was the first to come under Project Tiger initiative. Being the first national park of the country, Corbett faced a number of challenges during its initial stages. Initially, the park was the hunting ground of British officers. Edward Jim Corbett, who fought hard to set up a national park near the Ram Ganga River, was a hunter himself. In those days, man-wildlife conflict was a major issue faced by the local villagers of Nainital and Kamau region. Men used to consider the big cats as their biggest enemy and often planned to kill them by laying traps. Jim did thorough research to understand the actual reason behind tigers turning into man-eaters. He found that shrinking natural habitat, scarcity of available food, and random shooting are the major reasons behind tigers becoming man-eaters. To solve the issue, demarcating animal habitats from humans was necessary. Moreover, the tigers were needed to be protected against illegal poaching. That is why Jim started awareness among the villagers about the protection of wildlife. Later, the British government felt that necessity of protecting the wildlife and made the Corbett a protected area, which was later converted into a national park. The park has sub-Himalayan belt, geographical and ecological characteristics. Corbett National Park comprises 520.8 km square of hills, riverine belts, marshy depressions, grasslands and a large lake. The elevation ranges from 1300 to 4000 feet. Forests cover almost 73% of the park. 10% of the area consists of grasslands. It houses around 110 tree species, 50 species of mammals, 580 bird species and 25 reptile species. Dense, moist, deciduous forest mainly consists of sal, haldu, peepal, rohini and mango trees. Some of the major animal species found in Corbett are tigers, elephants, crocodile, hog deer, sambar, barking deer, leopards, langurs, wild boars, gharials, etc. The park is an ecotourism destination. Corbett has been a haunt for wildlife lovers for a long time. In 2014, approximately 3 lakh visitors visited the park, which has fetched a revenue of around 7 crore for the park and state. The habitat... Now I am going to be talking about challenges faced by this national park. The habitat of the reserve faces threats from invasive species such as the exotic weeds, lantana, parthenium and cassia. Natural resources like trees and grasses are exploited by the local population, while encroachment of at least 13.62 hectares by 74 families has been recorded. The increasing population growth rate and density of population within 1 km to 2 km from the park present a challenge to the management of the reserve. Incidents of killing cattle by tigers and leopards have led to acts of retaliation by the local population in some cases. The Indian government has approved the construction of a 12-kilometer stone masonry wall on the southern boundary of the reserve, where it comes in direct contact with the agricultural fields. In April 2008, the National Tiger Conservation Authority expressed serious concern that protection systems have weakened and poachers have infiltrated into the park. Monitoring of wild animals in the prescribed format has not been followed despite advisories and observations made during field visits. Also, the monthly monitoring report of field evidence relating to tigers has not been received since 2006. NTCA said that in the absence of ongoing monitoring protocol in a standardized manner, it would be impossible to forecast and keep track of untoward happenings in the area targeted by poachers. A cement road has been built through the path against a Supreme Court order. The road has become a thoroughfare between Kalagar and Ramnagar. Constantly increasing vehicle traffic on this road is affecting the wildlife of crucial ranges like Jhina, Koti Rao and Dhara. Additionally, the Kalagar irrigation colony that takes about 5 square kilometers of the park is yet to be vacated despite a 2007 Supreme Court order. A major incident in the history of the reserve followed the construction of a dam at the Kalagar River and the submerging of 80 kilometers square of prime low-lying riverine area. The consequences ranged from local extinction of swamp deer to a massive reduction in hog deer population. The reservoir formed due to the submerging of land has also led to an increase in aquatic fauna and has additionally served as the habitat for winter migratory birds. To track poachers in the park is brought under CCTV surveillance. An advanced software system called EI is set inside the park where 10 high-resolution cameras are spread across its 350 square kilometer area. The cameras are capable of capturing images of objects weighing more than 20 kg and sending alerts to the control room in the park along with NTCA office in Delhi. To reduce the number of wildlife poaching, a special tiger protection force comprising 112 personnel is going to be formed soon. They will be armed with the best ammunition. That's all for Jim Corbett National Park. Let's all pledge to protect. Thank you.